Well, to our Talanoa now, and as we heard, Cyclone Gabrielle is bearing down on the country with the threat of more devastation for families already reeling from the floods 2 weeks ago. What must they be feeling and what can they do? Joining us to share her thoughts is Auckland Councillor Josephine Bartley. Thank you for joining us on the show, Whaftse Lava.
Talofa Lava, my lolele, good morning. Thank you so much for having me on the show.
Our pleasure. Now, you've been out there in the coalface. You've seen a lot of the families as they've been affected by the flood. Tell us what they've been telling you and what you've seen there.
Yes, so I've been out there with our other elected members who've been going hard since last Friday when people first started contacting us about this river in their street. A lot of our people are feeling, well, quite a few that we saw in their homes were feeling like they had to fend for themselves, like they had to get themselves out of their homes while this river was flowing in their street. So pretty scary stuff out there that our communities have been dealing with. I think when they come into the evacuation centre, the ones that do come in, you know, it's a hard thing to ask for help. So, you know, when they're coming in, they're traumatised of what they've experienced. I've seen a lot of our families still staying in their homes, people expecting the army or someone to come through and help them like we see on the movies. So it's been a very, very hard time for our Pacific communities out there.
I know you've spoken out about what you've seen, and in terms of our people and the services being delivered fairly across the city, for much of South Auckland especially, do you think a lot of our community have not been served properly in this instance of the floods?
Yeah, I would say so. I mean, it's come down to our own Pasifika communities getting in there and helping each other, helping ourselves. I would love to see the army more out in South Auckland, especially in Māngele. Councillor Lotu Fuli has been running the clean-up coordination from the Māngere Evacuation Centre, which Councillor Alphilippaina, Tawa Nu'u, Nick Bakulich, the Māngere Otahu Local Board have been leading over there.
What about the council itself? I mean, obviously we've seen absolute failings that have happened here.
That's right, yes. I think we needed, for this one, going into Cyclone Gabrielle, there is better planning and better coordination happening, which is a relief. There's, our mayor is stepping into the role now, putting out those preparation messages, so that's good to see. That's what we want.
How much have things changed? Obviously, we didn't expect this to happen so soon. But even as of yesterday, sandbags were being delivered to other parts of Auckland, yet South Auckland was being missed out.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I don't know how these decisions are made, but in my mind, it would have been common sense to just put the sandbags where there's a community that's been flooded and a community where there are issues to accessing those sandbags, for example, affordability.
Okay, but they're on their way now. This morning they'll be available for people.
I understand there's going to be about 3,000 in Māngere.
Okay, we've just got a little moment to wrap up. What do you want to say to our community to be prepared?
For our communities, you take this seriously, be prepared. You could be at home for a period of time before help gets to you. So know that, you know, with this cyclone, wind will be a factor. That means trees are going to go down. That means our power is going to go out. So have 3 days' worth of water, about 9 litres per person. Have your medication in a waterproof bag, your documents, important documents, non-perishable food that you can survive on. And also a radio will be good for communication.
Councillor Bartley, Whaftse Lava, thank you for coming on the show today.
Thank you for having me.